First, no weeds in the immaculate lawns of Wimbledon, but there are some things that stand out when it comes to seeding. The seeds have been announced, all 32 on the men's and women's side at the All England Club. And the big news, eight-time champ Roger Federer, currently number three in the rankings, has been moved up to the number two seed. That means Rafa Nadal is demoted to number three. Last year's runner-up Kevin Anderson moves up four spots from 8 to 4. Marin Cilic goes from 18 to 13. They use a different formula at the All England Club, and so none of these top 8 seeds other than number 1 Novak Djokovic go according to their ranking, Nolsey.
Yeah, you know, the important thing is that Wimbledon has a formula. All the players know Wimbledon usually does what they want to do. And in this case, their formula is they take current ranking and then they have two bonuses as well, which basically highlight your grass court results. And obviously, you know, Roger Federer, one of the greatest grass court players of all time. And he had enough results in the last 52 weeks, which catapulted him, made up for the 1,300 points or so difference between he and Rafael Nadal.
All right, well, Rafa Nadal was not pleased that he was bumped down to number three. He said, the only thing that does not seem right to me is that only Wimbledon does it. If everyone did it, meaning all the other Grand Slams, I think it would be appropriate. It is better to be second than third, but if they consider that I have to be third, I will accept. Now, top seed Novak Djokovic, he can empathize with Rafa. Listen to this.
That's their rules, and we've got to respect it. Although it's a little bit surprising, to be honest, even though it's Roger. I mean, Roger is, you know, the greatest of all time, and of course, you know, he won most Wimbledon titles of any player in the history, and you know, if anyone deserves it, it's him. But at the same time, you know, it's Nadal that he's kind of taking over the second seed. You know, so it is a surprising, to be honest, a little bit, but. You know, it is what it is.
So Djokovic says it's surprising. Are you surprised, Chanda?
A little bit. I mean, you can go either way. Obviously, this is Roger Federer, so, you know, some people maybe not up in arms about it for that reason. But it's not great for Nadal, who's played so well over the last, you know, 12 months, has earned that seeding. Our research guys have figured out that it's probably that 2017 Wimbledon where Roger won and Nadal got to the round of 16. That made the biggest difference. And, you know, you consider how tough it is to win the French Open and Wimbledon back-to-back, and Rafa Nadal has challenged himself year after year to continue to try to do that. Federer didn't play the clay court, so you could maybe imagine that Nadal is thinking Federer is still getting the benefits of not having played the clay season, focusing on the grass in 2017, and 2 years later, he's getting the benefits, and it's to the disadvantage of Nadal.
Does Rafa have a gripe here, Nolsey?
Well, I mean, the fact of the matter is of course, Rafa has a bit of a gripe as far as if you were looking at it just in clear terms. But the reality is there's a formula in place. The bigger issue to me is whether the formula should still be in place. It's one that came about when there was a huge disparity between clay and grass. Now the surfaces are more similar. They play fairly slow. Grass plays a lot slower than it used to in the past. So you maybe don't have the grass court specialist so much as you maybe had in the past. You can think of guys like maybe Milos Raonic, guys that are much better on the grass. But for me, the rule is in place. The thing that's important to realize is that grass, how many events do we have on grass? We have 7 events on grass. So it's a very small season. When you look at clay, we have about 20 events on clay. You look at hard, we have about 34 events. So, you know, the reason Wimbledon put it in play is because it's such a short, little, concise season for the grass, and they feel that there are grass court players that elevate their game on that surface. So from that standpoint, I think the issue should be more with, hey, do we need to kind of abolish this formula and just go according to the rankings?
And the formula states they take 100% of your points from the past 12 months, the immediate past 12 months, add those to your current ranking, and then they take 75% of the points from the 12 months prior to that. As you mentioned, Chanda, that's when Roger won Wimbledon and Rafa lost in the round of 16, because entering the tournament this year, Rafa's ahead by more than 1,300 points.
So and I think the issue for Rafa really is if you think back to last year, he made the semifinals and essentially could have won the tournament. He lost 8-6 in the fifth to Novak, which was an epic match. And, you know, if you're looking at it, those are the top three guys to win the championships this year. So, you know, the problem with Rafa is obviously he understands there's a big difference between being 2 and 3. Obviously now he can play, he can possibly have to play somebody else before he plays Novak in the final. Kevin Anderson got the 4 seed on the other side. So I get it. I think there's arguments from both sides. I think the thing that needs to be addressed more than anything is whether they need to still have the formula in place.
In your opinion, yes or no, should they have that formula in place?
You know, I probably think they shouldn't. I really don't. I think when you think about who are grass court specialists, we just saw Feliciano Lopez last week in Queens. He's a great grass court player. He's just too far down in the rankings to impact the seeding. Nicholas Mahut, another guy who's won a lot of his titles on grass, but I don't think we see it so much as we saw in the past. So I would be in favor of getting rid of it, and that way you just follow the rankings. Two amazing, two of the greatest players ever. Of course, Roger Federer clearly is the greatest grass court player of all time, but Rafael Nadal has done pretty well as well with two titles at Wimbledon, so he's no slouch on grass.
Well, on the women's side, they do not have a formula. They go by the WTA rankings, and that means that Ash Barty is your top seed heading into the championships, riding a 12-match win streak. She took the title, of course, at the French Open, her first Grand Slam, and then won in Birmingham last week. So she will be your top seed at Wimbledon, a former junior champ, but she's never been past the third round in singles at the All England Club. Last player to win Roland Garros and Wimbledon back-to-back was Serena Williams in 2015. So here are your top seeds on the women's side. And by the way, they can change the seeds if they want to at Wimbledon. That's, they go by the rankings, except where, in the opinion of the committee, a change is necessary to produce a balanced draw. They have done that in the past with Serena Williams. Chanda, they did not do that this year, and she is seeded 11th.
Yeah, I think that, to me, is one of the problems with how arbitrary the changing of the seedings are. They did not do it at all on the women's side, and if they did, Serena would have moved up to 7 as opposed to 11, which makes a big difference. She's a finalist from last year. Angie Kerber as well would have moved up, I think, to number two, as opposed to number 5. As a defending champ, that would be huge. And so I don't understand. It seems like a double standard. I don't understand why they don't do it for the women if it's that important and if that's something they're trying to do across the board and the formula is supposed to make sense. To me, it's still too arbitrary, and I kind of agree with Mark. I don't think they should have it. I think they should just go by the seedings, unless maybe somebody who's coming back that should just be seeded as opposed to moving them up according to a formula.
Yeah, just go by the rankings. I mean, Nolte, what's your viewpoint on the fact that it's different for the men and the women there?
100% agree with Chanda. I think it should be the same for sure. But, you know, one thing that's important here is I was on tour for a long time. Chanda was, Wimbledon does it Wimbledon's way. And so that's all I'm saying from Rafael's standpoint is that you know that going in, that Wimbledon always kind of sets itself aside from the rest. That's just the way that they operate. And for me, if anyone has the biggest beef, it's Serena Williams. Yeah. 11th seed, she's the best player on grass, in my opinion. So until somebody proves that different, I'm having Serena top 8, as you mentioned.
Yeah, I mean, that's a huge difference, right? Being a top 8 seed as opposed to outside?
No, absolutely. And, you know, you look at who she could end up playing in the third round and in the fourth round. It changes the draw tremendously, and it would be deserved if you put her there based on the formula. Because, again, we have this formula that seems very precise, so Wimbledon does it their own way. But use it across the board, in my opinion.
All right. Well, she's an 8-time champ. We'll see if she can add some more. 7-time champ there at Wimbledon. Much more still to come here.